Hey friends, hey, it's your girl Vondra, and welcome back to my channel, Typical Black Queen.
Like a queen,
like a queen, like a queen,
queen upon her throne.
So I want to start off again by apologizing again. If you hear some sounds outside, they're cutting the grass, of course, right when I'm trying to record, because they don't like to see us sisters be ahead in the YouTube game. Like, why you gotta cut grass now? You had all weekend to cut grass and you wanted to cut grass now. If you're new here, welcome. Nice to see you. Nice to meet you. Drop your name below so I can get to know you. And in order to get to know me on a more personal level, you have to do one thing and one thing only, and that is hit that red subscribe button below. If you will also like to get to know me a little bit more extensively, deep down personally, you can follow me on Instagram at Typical Black Queen. You can tap the link in the description box to sign up for my newsletter, The Vibe. I know y'all are tired of seeing these flat twists. I'm tired of seeing them. My scalp is itchy. My hair is dirty. My son took a picture of my scalp yesterday and it was like flakes galore. So it's time for a wash day. But that's not what this video is about. This video, I'm going to help you out. So when it's time for you to stretch your hair with heat, you do it safely. I'm doing another protective style because I have not been in the mood to do my hair. And when I get in those moods, my hair tends to break off, become damaged, brittle, dry, and I just ain't rocking like that. I'm gonna take initiative to take care of my hair. So I know when I get a certain way, I'm just gonna go ahead and have my hair put into a pretty and cute protective style. So enough of me talking about it, let's get into this video. So I'm not gonna be really showing y'all my wash day. I have several wash day videos that I'll link in one of these corners that you can watch fully on another time, but we're gonna be talking about right now. My hair is giving crispity, crackety, crunchity. I have not wrapped my hair up. I've been laying on my cotton pillowcase. I don't have a silk pillowcase because every time I like use a silk pillowcase, my pillows end up on the floor. It's something about there's not being any traction. So when I do become a complete lazy natural, my hair takes the brunt end of that. I know I gotta do better. I know I have to do better. So when I stretch my hair, the way I like to stretch it is when it's fully, wow, Southeast. And stretching my hair with, okay. There's always something going on. When stretching my hair, I prefer to do it on freshly washed hair when my hair is like super drenched in water. I feel like I get the utmost stretched to the ability of my hair that can be stretched. So with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and start my wash day. Wash day is completed and I did my right side off camera because I didn't want this to be like a super long video. So I'm going to be showing you on my left side how I stretch my hair with heat and my blow dryer. And I'll link my blow dryer down below. For the leave-in conditioner, I'm using the Cream of Nature Strength and Shine 4-in-1 Leave-In Conditioner. This is a water-based conditioner, so it's perfect for styling your hair when it's damp or wet. Because my hair is so thick, working in smaller sections when I'm stretching my hair out gives me the ultimate like stretch. So I'm going to take a smaller section from the bigger side and detangle that. I've used a few heat protectants in my stretching days, but this one right here, it works the best. It's very oily based. It's kind of thick, so you don't need a lot, but it definitely protects my hair. I do not recommend this though if you have very fine hair or thin hair, because this is a heavy product. I like using it because as you can see, my hair is just dense and thick for no reason. Once you comb or brush that through, you can get right to stretching your hair. I like to hold my hair at the end very tight and taut. I don't use a brush until the end, and I just go back and forth with the low heat in a swiping motion. It is not until this point that I use my Denman brush. You can use any type of brush with the stickies on it. This is just to get my ends a lot smoother. The holding my hair taut is to get the base, the roots, and like the length of my hair straight. And then I do this method to get the ends of my hair straight. Thank you.
This is what my hair looks like fully blown out. Well, I wouldn't even say it's fully because I've gone to a hairstylist and they blew my hair out way straighter than this. As you can see, my left side was done really half-assed, so it's not as stretched as the right, but it's okay because my protective style is still gonna work with this. So here's a personal tip that I use when stretching my hair with heat. I use the least amount of leave-in conditioner and thermal heat protectant because I know I'm going to be styling my hair after this and actually putting more product in it. And especially if you want to flat iron your hair straight, it's going to weigh it down and be greasy. So try to use as least as possible, but you know, covering your hair. And this is the final look. Your girl got some jumbo knotless braids. And for you DMV kings and queens, I make sure I'll link my braider in the description box below. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up and leave me a comment. And we all know sharing is caring. And if you really loved it, don't forget to hit the red subscribe button below. Until next time, girlfriends, see you later.